After this video, you can start with server-side tracking. I'm Ate Keurentjes, server-side tracking specialist, and in the last year and a half, I conducted more than 100 server-side setups for various clients. And in this video, I will show you the steps you need to make to start with server-side tracking, which allows you to make the shift from third-party to first-party data collection and collect more and valuable data as the ones you see right here. So, you're about to make the shift to server-side tracking. In my opinion, this is the right choice. You're transitioning to first-party data collection, ensuring a future-proof tracking setup that can dynamically be adjusted. Additionally, you'll benefit from several other advantages, and here are the most important ones. You get more data, higher data quality, more control, faster website due to fewer scripts, and you become GDPR proof. I won't get into details further in this video, because if you watch this video, you probably already know why you need to start, but just don't know how to start. But I must inform you, yes, it takes time, yes, it costs money, and yes, things will go wrong. But that's part of the process. The tracking landscape is becoming more complex, and that's the life of a marketeer right now. Tracking is only going to become more important in the upcoming years. And as it stands now, server-side tracking seems to be the best solution. Now, let me show you the steps to best approach this so you'll have a future-proof tracking setup ready in no time. So, what do we need in advance? First, let's look at what we were working with. We're using Google Tag Manager because it's easy to adjust and therefore future-proof. Do you already have a Google Tag Manager setup? Server-side tracking will integrate with your existing setup, making it easy to test. Ensure that Google Analytics is linked with Google Tag Manager so that the data from your website flows to GA4. And there are many guides available on this topic, so I won't go in further in the details right here. And you also need basic knowledge of Google Tag Manager. With server-side tracking, an additional server is introduced into the process. Here's what the data flow will look like. You have a person who visits your website. That data will be structured into the data layer and will go to Google Tag Manager. And then the data will go from Google Tag Manager web container to the server container, as you can see on the screen. And from the server container, it will flow to the relevant platforms like Google Analytics, Facebook, Google Ads, and other platforms. Next is choosing the right hosting. With server-side tracking, an additional server is incorporated into your own infrastructure, similar to how you host a website. And this server requires monthly hosting fees, and the cost often depended on the size of the website, meaning how much data flows through your website, basically. So on the screen, you see the extra server incorporated. So here's some things you can consider when choosing the right server-side tracking hosting. Do you need the hosting with a lot of features, or are you just okay with the basics? Do you want maintenance contracts, or do you prefer to minimize expenses? Some server-side tracking hosting companies have analytics functions to see what server-side tracking actually delivers for you. Like you can see the extra data, or some people find it unnecessary and just want the hosting. Do you want to be the servers located into your own country for GDPR compliance, or is that not a priority to you? Can you set up everything yourself, or do you need a good chat or live chat support? And the good news is that you can easily switch between hosting providers by changing your subdomain. So choose your hosting and get started. So I mentioned the word subdomain. Yes, the data now runs through your subdomain with server-side tracking. A subdomain is a part of your main domain that's linked to other sections of your website. For example, blog.yoursite or shop.yoursite are subdomains of yoursite.com. And this allows you to make the shift from third party to first party because the subdomain is in your hands and that is making it first party data collection. So what server-side tracking provider I recommend? I recommend TAGGRS, not just because I work there, but because it has unique features that no one else offers. Like they have server-side analytics, You can easily see how much extra data you get with surf set tracking, making it easy to test. TAGGRS is the only one on the market that has this feature, so I really like it. They also have an independent infrastructure. They're not dependent on Google Cloud environment, which provides advantages for GDPR compliance. They have a Google Tag Manager template gallery, so you can set up the basics of surf set tracking in just a few clicks. I will talk about this also later in this video. Those are preset templates made by tracking specialists, which you can copy and apply to your own server-side configuration. And they're also cost-effective. They're one of the most affordable options in the market right now, and you can start for free to check it out for yourself. And if you want to support me and this channel, you can create an account through the link in the description, and this will be appreciated. When setting up your hosting account, it's essential that your data routing is configured through the hosting. This is achieved by creating a subdomain and adjusting your DNS settings within your website hosting provider's control panel. This way, the data flows through the server, and otherwise, so if you don't do this, you can't run server-side tracking. After you chose your hosting providers and set up your subdomain, you need to determine if you need a data layer on your website. A data layer structures your website data in a way that allows you to use this information for your tags and triggers. If you want to track events such as purchases, add to cart, and actions, and etc., it's important to implement a data layer on your website. For B2B websites, this is often not necessary because it's already built in Google Tag Manager itself. Most CMS platforms offer free plugins or add-ons that you can download for this purpose. TAGGRS also has their own plugins / add-ons that you can find in your TAGGRS account that are free to use, so you can implement a data layer in just a few clicks. So now, which platforms do you wish to measure? This involves setting up all the tags and triggers for the platforms you want to track. In this case, I will take a basic WooCommerce webshop. I've added a data layer using a data layer plugin of TAGGRS, which you can see in the video. As I said, we're gonna do a basic WooCommerce webshop, setting up Google Analytics 4, Google Ads, and Facebook. Now, Google Tag Manager comes into play. You need to set up a server container with tags, triggers, and variables. The challenging part is that everything needs to be slightly different in the server container that you're used to in the web container if you already have set up some things in Google Tag Manager. You might be used setting up the Facebook pixel, but in the server container this becomes the Facebook conversion API. So you now have two ways to set it up in Tag Manager. You can do a manual setup, or you can use the Google Tag Manager templates of TAGGRS. So the first way is through templates. TAGGRS offers a comprehensive template gallery with pre-configured server-side tracking templates for popular content management systems like WordPress, Shopify, Magento, like all the popular ones. These templates speed up the implementation process and are created by experts, and they're easy to use. And the second one is through manual setup. For full control over your tracking setup, you can always choose to configure it manually. This is ideal for companies that want to migrate or refine their existing tracking infrastructure, and TAGGRS offers step-by-step guides and videos for this, as you can see in the video right on your screen. In this case, for our basic WooCommerce webshop, we will go for a template. I created my account on TAGGRS and configured everything so that the data flows through the subdomain. Now I went to the TAGGRS template gallery, as you can see in the video, and I will download the file. And then we're gonna import this file into Google Tag Manager. And we need to make sure we need to do this for both web and server container. And as you can see right here in the video, I will import the web version. It is in this video, default workspace, import the container, confirm. Now, when we go to tags, you will see all the tags are already there. And that's from the template. So after you've implemented the template into your own configuration, you need to go to variables, and here you will need to fill in the correct codes URLs wherever it says fill in. So in this case, I will need to fill in the Facebook pixel ID, GA4 measurement ID, the TAGGRS container ID, which can be found on your dashboard. And if you fill this in, these variables will dynamically be adjusted to all the tags and triggers that are just implemented through the template. Then you can pause or remove tags that you won't need. As I said, we're basic WooCommerce, so we only needed the Facebook, the Google Ads and Google Analytics. So I paused all the other tags that comes with the template. So in this case, you will see that I paused all the Bing tags. The result of this configuration will be a field in web container and a field in server container, filled with all the codes I provided into the variables. Then we're arriving at one of the most important things I'm gonna say today. And with the introduction of server side tracking, testing has also slightly changed within Google Tag Manager. You have another preview mode, as you can see right here on the screen. Well, we have our situation of our web shot on the left, and then we have a web preview, as you're maybe used to, but we also have a new server preview. So there wasn't any guide to find on the internet on how to do this properly. So for this reason, I've written a comprehensive testing guide where I guide you step by step through the process of testing your server side setup. You have now set up server side tracking for your website, and you can check out the results in your TAGGRS dashboard if you chose for TAGGRS, obviously. And in this example, you see that I have a 20% increase in measured data for my website, which goes straight into my, in this case, Google Ads campaigns. If the data graphs show you something different than that you expected, TAGGRS has a debug series where you can find solutions and insights for the most common situations when using their software. This way you can get up and running quickly and optimize your data collection. So, where do most server-side implementations go wrong? Here are the top three things. First one is misunderstanding the data layer. Google allowed users to determine their own data layer structure, resulting in a variety of data layers on the market. This diversity in configuration means that the variables you need to extract from your data layer can be varied depending on the setup. So the solution for this is make sure when you're using the TAGGRS template gallery that you choose the right template with the right data layer. So the second biggest mistake is duplicate tracking tags on your website. In some cases, the Google Tag Manager script is loaded multiple ways in the code, often through manual placement or through another plugin, as you can see on your screen. The other, they literally hijack the request from the correct GTM code, preventing that not all requests are being sent to the server container. So you can check this for yourself by right-clicking on your website, then go to inspect and search for GTM or collect in elements. And if you see two codes, you need to make sure you only leave the right one. And you can remove the other one. So there are some hosting providers that offers the option to implement their script through your hosting for anonymizing or for ad blockers. And it's sometimes forgotten to remove the other scripts from your website. And the last one, the third one, is not reading instructions carefully. Mistakes are easily made, so take it seriously. As I mentioned at the beginning, it takes time, so take your time. A mistake can be easily made. If just one trigger or something is incorrect, your tracking will fail. So, are you ready? I just want to mention, yes, every website is different and you will most likely encounter things that are not common. This is where you as a marketeer can distinguish yourself. And if you're not sure you've covered everything, check out this free checklist I've created, and I will put the link to this checklist into the bio of this video. You now know how you can start with server-side tracking. Great job. Do you need more information? Feel free to send me a personal message on LinkedIn anytime. And again, if you want to support the channel or me, you can create an account with TAGGRS through the link in the description, and this will be much appreciated. Good luck with your service tracking journey, and as always, happy tagging!